So our next question is related to tsunami speed and evacuation time. So quite a few questions, well, people were interested in this. So we've got a question from Phil. Phil has asked about how quickly tsunami wave travels. He and Susie, who live in Napier, would like to know how much time do they have to evacuate following an earthquake along the Hickory subduction zone. Sandra's also asked a kind of similar question. So Sandra would like to know if a tsunami, how long would it take for a tsunami to reach Palmerston North or Foxton. And Hazel and Tanya from Christchurch want to know if there's a tsunami, how far inland do we need to go? So William, you're the tsunami expert that we've got online tonight. So William, can you tell us a bit more about tsunami speed and evacuation times, please?
Yep, certainly. Hello, everybody. As far as the speed that a tsunami travels at, it's a function of how deep the water is. Essentially, the speed is proportional to the square root of the water depth. So when you're in the really deep ocean and it's about 4 kilometers deep, then the tsunami can travel at about 700 kilometers an hour, so the speed of a jet aircraft. But as it comes into shallower water, it slows down. So in about 100 meters depth of water, the tsunami would be traveling at about 110 kilometers an hour, so the speed of a fast car. And by the time you get to 10 meters water depth, it'd be traveling at about 35 kilometers per hour. So slow moving car or very fast running person. So then the question of how long does a tsunami take to reach the coast becomes down to two factors. One is, where is the tsunami exactly generated? So the tsunami is generated by movement of the seabed. So how close to the coast is that movement taking place? And what is the shape of the seabed between where the tsunami is generated and the coast that you're at? So it's a little bit tricky to give general answers to this because we often don't really know in advance how the pattern of movement of the seabed is exactly going to be. So I try and answer your question using the example that we looked at for the Hickorangi response plan. So this was a magnitude 8.9 Hickorangi subduction zone earthquake. And when we modeled that propagating to Napier, we found that the peak of the first wave arrived about 30 to 50 minutes after the earthquake. So that's varying depending exactly where you are along the Napier coastline. For Gisborne, we found that a bit less. So the equivalent was about 20 to 40 minutes. So if you're thinking, so if we, let's focus on Napier for now, you've got about, if you aim for half an hour, that's probably a pretty good target for trying to get to safety. I would say though, you know, just get ready and go as soon as you safely can, because it could take you longer to get to safety than you think. It could be crowded. If you get there early, that's good. You can move away beyond the evacuation line and leave space for the people who are behind you. A few words of caution. So sometimes if you're right down by the coast, there may be some earlier waves. So if you're right down on the beach or around the river estuary, it's a good idea to move out of those areas pretty quickly. So that's the first question. If I go to the second question, which is about Palmerston North and Foxton. So that one, well, I don't think there's any risk of a tsunami reaching Palmerston North, the main city itself. That's too far inland. Foxton, we'd have to split that between talking about Foxton itself and Foxton Beach. So Foxton, the main town, is far enough from the coast that it's the residential and commercial parts of town are outside of the tsunami evacuation zone. What you do have to be careful of is tsunamis can be quite good at traveling up rivers. So you could have a wave going up the Manawatu River. So I would, you know, I think you need to keep away from the Manawatu River, its floodplains and the tributary of the Manawatu River that goes around through to near to Foxton. So as long as you stay away from the river, I think you're okay in Foxton. Foxton Beach is a different story because that's right right by the coast and quite low lying in places. So Foxton Beach is definitely is within the tsunami evacuation zone. And that's definitely a place where you feel the long or strong earthquake, you want to get gone quickly. Around times, it's a little difficult. We don't have any detailed modeling. Some of the faults offshore of the Foxton Beach area are relatively close. So although those particular faults are relatively low activity, so relatively low chance that you get a tsunami from them, but they are close. So small chance it could arrive, you know, within a few minutes. So do go quickly as a precaution, but that's mostly precautionary. So what's the next question was about Christchurch. Shall I go on to that one, Kate?
Yeah, yes, please, William.
So there's a question about how far inland should you go in Christchurch to avoid tsunamis? And the answer there is it is very variable. And the best thing really is to go to look at the Christchurch City Council website. And if you search for Christchurch tsunami evacuation maps, you'll see how much variation there is. So as I mentioned about Foxton, tsunamis can travel quite a long way up rivers. So along the Avon and Heathcote rivers, you know, you can get several kilometers from the coast and you're still in the tsunami evacuation zone. Whereas if you're in one of the hilly suburbs on the south side of the harbor, the tsunami might only go, you know, 100 meters or so. So it's very variable and best to look at the council tsunami evacuation maps. I think there was one other question about someone in Bishopsdale in Christchurch. I think Bishopsdale is quite a long way from the coast. I don't believe there's any tsunami risk to Bishopsdale.